After creating the database system, it is advisable to come up with a friendly user interface to enable the end user navigate through the system with minimum guidance. AMS Access provides us with switchboard functionality for this purpose. Throughout this video, I'll guide you on how to create a professional switchboard and add buttons on it automated by macros. We'll start by creating a dashboard where all objects will be accessed by a single click. To create a dashboard, we need to design a form and then add buttons for opening the forms, queries and reports, and finally an exit button to close the database. Now, that's what I'm doing. I'm going to make use of controls such as labels for headings, buttons for navigation buttons, and apply some formatting features to enhance the appearance. For example, this is labels, whereby I'm going to type rent management system, apply some little formatting. Design again, I can get another label for headings, for data entry forms, queries and reports. I will insert only one label, modify it and then copy it for the others instead of just inserting new labels every time. After the labels, I'll insert buttons and attach them with macros to automate them to open specific forms, queries, and reports as shown here. Now let us label the first button as tenants and tenants registration. Please begin here. We are going to add a macro on this button by right-clicking it and then selecting build event. Using a macro, and this macro should enable us to open a form, and the form should be tenants form. Save and close. Let us test whether it is working. First of all, let us save our dashboard and open it in form view. Clicking it, it will work. That's what we mean by automating the dashboard using the macros. Having done with the first button, let us make the button more attractive by formatting it. And after formatting it, we shall be repeating the same procedure for all other buttons. Apply a macro and then format the button. So for now, we are in the second button, that is rent payment. Delete this macro and add a new macro for opening a form. And this form should be known as payment. Save. After that, we save and close. We are adding another button for queries, that is for statement query. So let me copy the existing button for data entry, rename it as statement. You can call it statement, or it is rent statement. Yeah, that's a good name. Then right click. Change the macro. It is no longer opening a form, but it will be about open a query. Open query, enter, and the query name is statement. Once you type this S, it will just appear there. Save and close. The same applies for reports. You can see it is still working. The format in it that with a different background color, that let me copy it and use the same sync button to create report button. Only that I will change the macro such that originally it was to open a report, but now it was originally to open a query, but now it will, its main purpose will be opening a report. So after renaming it, right click and build an event. The event is no longer open query but open report, and the report name is tenants statement. Save and close. The report will work. We can confirm so by going to form view, but let us first of all wind up with all the reports. So payment report. Again, build an event. It is no longer opening the tenant statement, but opening a report by name. What's the name of the report? Payment report. Then save it. So let us rename, change the background color by choosing another quick style. That is maybe black one can be okay. And then let us confirm they are working. Actually, they are working perfectly. We need to add a final button for exiting the database as shown here. This time around, I'll use command button wizard. Its purpose, application, quit, application, next. Can give it a specific name, exit. So such that when we click the button, the whole database will be closed. So after that, we can enlarge it and apply a different color to differentiate it from the others. Now let me remove the blank space just below the report and open my report. Now this is how it will look like. The dashboard, all buttons are working. After all of this, we need to add another welcoming screen and name it as splash screen, such that when we open a database, it will be the one displayed on the screen. And we are going to automate it such that when we click anywhere, the screen will lead us to the dashboard. How? Just see it. First of all, we design it and customize it in our own way. And then after that, right click in a blank space. Then build an event. And the event is a macro builder. And it is on click. What should happen on click? It should open a form. What is the name of the form? It should be the dashboard. Open our form and click anywhere. You can see it is responding. I'm going to save our welcoming screen as splash screen. The same splash screen, we can add another functionality such that when we click it, it will open the dashboard and close itself, close the window. Save and close. You should not be prompted, then save. Let us test its functionality because it's working. Now let us hide the objects bar and also make sure that when you open our database, the splash screen is displayed automatically. Start by giving our system a new name, Rent Management Information System. Then display form, it should be the splash screen. And then let us try it. Click OK. And close our DB. So opening it. Wow, a new step. Click anywhere to continue. Amazing. Let us now hide these access objects bar. So I'm going to File, Options, Current Database, and go down to Navigation. From All Navigation, and check Display Navigation Pane. Then you click OK. And then restart our database. Splash screen only displays here, and if you want to access anything else, we just click anywhere to access the dashboard. Is mission accomplished? As we honor this guy's request, let me know your videos of interest in comment sections so that I may upload them in future. A like to this video and a subscription is like a prayer said. Goodbye.